It's the start of a new year, a new release cycle, and WebStorm 2022.1 is getting ready for release. Hi, I'm Paul Everett, JetBrains Developer Advocate. This new release brings expanded framework support, new features, IDE refinements, and bug fixes. Let's take a look at what's new in WebStorm 2022.1. You know what's gotten really popular in the last year? Next.js, and thanks to WebStorm's built-in React support, many Next.js features were already there, but WebStorm 2022.1 adds support for some framework-specific things such as pages. If you are in a link component, the IDE will resolve paths for your href attributes. As you can see, the file extension is stripped off to match the route. If you provide an invalid path, you'll get a warning and mouseover will give you some helpful information. The IDE will resolve paths used in the href attribute of your link components, as well as in the form and the other tags that use that. Code completion, navigation, and refactorings will also work. Managing your Node.js versions and installations can be a pain. To help, there's a new kit on the block, Volta, and WebStorm 2022.1 supports it. In this project, WebStorm picked up a Node.js and a Yarn installation managed in the .volta directory. Nothing special, it just works, which is nice. You can read more about Volta on their webpage. It's an exciting project. This release also supports Corepack, an experimental Node.js tool that lets you use Yarn and PNPM without having to install them. You can read more about Corepack on the Node.js documentation page. We've been hard at work on our Docker support, and 2022.1 has some notable changes. First, we reworked Docker's UI in the Services tool window. The makeover has been implemented for containers and images, networks, and volumes. We also added support for the Docker Registry HTTP API version 2 to use with Docker 1.6+. You can create simple or password-protected Docker version 2 v2 registries and perform all of the usual actions like viewing and pushing and pulling images. Here's a nice little touch. Ever use README files to describe common commands to run? Yeah, me. Now you can just run them. Let's say you have a Markdown file that includes an npm or yarn command to run. In the editor's gutter, you now have a play icon to execute that script. If you are previewing your Markdown instead of editing, then there's no gutter and the play button is inline in the text. We also added a new copy code snippet action to the preview for Markdown blocks. This lets you quickly copy their contents to the clipboard. Finally, we've reworked the floating toolbar that appears on text selection, a new design, and helps work with styles and lists and more. I use the split tools window in WebStorm a lot to show two files at once. In 2022.1, we implemented a little refinement for those who like to reorganize their split workspace. You can now configure split tabs to have the same width. To do this, go to Preferences or Settings, and then Advanced Settings, and select the new Equalize Proportions in Nested Splits options. This works with default usage of tabs, as well as no tabs, which is what I use. Our version control integration, really popular. 2022.1 improves the Annotate with Git Blame to make investigating introduced changes easier. Now the IDE highlights the differences in lines right in the editor when you hover over an annotation, and opens the log tab under the Git tool window when you click on it. That's not all for WebStorm 2022.1. Also in this release, WebStorm 2022.1 comes with several improvements for View 3. If you define components globally, the IDE will now recognize them in your .view files. WebStorm should support the create app syntax. It will correctly match applications created using create app with their related elements. Support for Next 3 has been added as well. Starting with this release, Webpack Coding Assistance will work with ESM. For JavaScript and TypeScript, the structure view now shows symbols in a more logical and visual order. And that's a tour of what's new in WebStorm 2022.1, a release focused on refinements with a few new features sprinkled in. Thanks for watching this video, and thanks for using WebStorm.